असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल ऑन पोर्टर गवर्नर. लर्निंग आउटकम. एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिटरमाइन द इक्विलिब्रियम स्पीड एफर्ट एंड पावर इन पोर्टर गवर्नर. So, the statement of the problem, the upper arms of the Porter governor has length of 350 mm and are pivoted on the axis of rotation. The lower arm of length 300 mm and are attached to the sleeve at a distance of 40 mm from the axis of rotation. Each ball has mass of 4 kg and mass of sleeve is 45 kg. Determine the equilibrium speed for the radius of rotation of 200 mm and also find the effort and power of the governor for 1% speed change. So, first of all, we will write down the given data. So what is given? The length of the arm, that is PB, it is given 350 mm. Lower arm, that is BD, it is given 300 mm. The sleeve is attached at a radial distance of 40 mm as shown in the figure. So 40 mm from the axis of rotation. Each ball has mass of 4 kg and mass of sleeve 45 kg. We have to find out the equilibrium speed of the governor at the radius of rotation r is equal to 200 mm. And also we have to find out the governor effort and power when the increase in the speed is 1%, that is 0.01. So the configuration of the Porter governor is as shown in the figure. Alpha, it is the angle of inclination of the arm with the axis of the spindle. Beta is the angle of inclination of the link with the vertical. So from this we have to calculate the equilibrium speed. So first of all, we have to calculate the height of the governor. So height of the governor H is equal to PG, that is equal to, now if you see the triangle PBG, it is a right angle triangle. So according to the Pythagoras theorem, the length of PG, that will be equal to BP square minus BG square. So put the value of BP and BG, that is PB is 350 mm bracket square minus BG, that is 200 square. So the height of the governor H, that will be equal to 0.28 meter. Now we have to calculate the angle of inclination of the arm with the vertical. So again from the triangle PBG, tan alpha is equal to opposite, that is BG divided by PG. So you know the BG, that is the radius of rotation 200, PG, that height we have calculated as 0.287, so it is 287 mm, and from this by doing the calculation you can calculate the value of tan alpha and it will be equal to 0.697. Now the next thing, triangle BHD. So the radius of rotation BG is given 200 mm, HG is 40 mm. So we have to calculate the length DH. So this length DH we have to calculate, and therefore the length dh is equal to under root bd square minus bh square from the diagram. So bh, this length bh, so radius of rotation bz is 200 mm, and this 40, so 200 minus 40, the value of bh is 160 mm, and therefore you can calculate the value of dh. So bd is 300 mm square minus bh, it is 160 square, and therefore the length of dh is 254 mm. In meter it is 0.254 meter. Next, we can calculate the angle of inclination beta. So tan beta is equal to opposite side BH divided by this adjacent side DH. So we know the value of BH, 160 mm, DH already we have calculated 254 mm, and from this the value of tan beta is 0.63. Then Q is ratio of tan beta divided by tan alpha. So already we have calculated the value of tan alpha and tan beta, so putting the value of this you will get Q is equal to 0.904. And now we can calculate the equilibrium speed of the governor. So n square is equal to m plus capital M by 2 into in bracket 1 plus Q divided by M into 895 divided by H. So putting that value, mass of the ball is 4 kg. So 4 plus 45 divided by 2 into 1 plus 0.904 divided by M 4 into 895 divided by height of the governor 0.287. So by putting these values and doing the calculation, you will get the speed of the governor as 191 rpm. So this is the equilibrium speed of the governor corresponding to the radius of rotation 200 mm. Now next we have to calculate the effort of the governor. So effort of the governor is represented by letter P, and in case of Porter governor the effort is given by C into 2m divided by 1 plus Q plus capital M into G. Now in this case alpha and beta are not same, and therefore by putting the value 0.01 into 2 into 4 divided by 1 plus Q value is 0.904 into M, that is 45, into G 9.81. So by putting the value you can calculate the effort of the governor, that will be equal to 4.8 newton. And also you can calculate the power of the governor. So power of the governor is given by 4c square upon 1 plus 2c inside the bracket M plus capital M divided by 2 into 1 plus Q bracket complete into G into H. So put the value 4 into 0.01 bracket square divided by 1 plus 2 into 0.01 inside the bracket 4 plus 45 divided by 2 into 1 plus 0.904 multiply by 9.8 into height 0.287. So put these values in the equation, and by doing the calculation calculate the power of the governor, and that will be equal to 0.052 newton meter, or it is 52 newton mm. So this is the power of the governor. This particular content is referred from the book of Theory of Machines by Khurmi R. Thank you.